What's up guys and welcome to a new video. As you can see in the title, we are gonna show all the animals, or I'm gonna show all the animals that I own. What I wanna do is start off with the stick insects, tell you guys everything that happened in the meantime. Then I will show you all the other animals that I own, so not insects, not stick insects. And there are actually more than you may think in this house. They're not all mine, but you know, we all care for them, so they're basically from everyone. I'm gonna start off with the stick insects. There happened a lot of things, so yeah, let's show you that right now.
Alright, the first that I want to show you, of course, is the Heteropteryx dilatata. She is here in her enclosure, and you may already see a major difference here. She started to mate, of course, so she did actually got fertilized, or I don't know how you should be calling that, but she mated with her male, which I don't see at the moment. I think he's hiding somewhere, but I don't see him. But what is very obvious to see is that she got a lot thicker, so she's also eating a lot. She lays quite a lot of poopies, as you can see here. So yeah, she's really gaining a lot of weight, and I'm pretty sure she's gonna lay a lot of eggs soon, so that's very nice. All right, the next big thing, which is actually a really literally big thing, are my Tiraguidias. And actually 1 hour ago, before I was filming this, I actually found this male, and there was one weird thing that I noticed, and that is that he has wings. He actually got wings from his molt. I have no idea if he can fly. That actually scared me, but I'm just gonna leave him here. And here's my female, and my female is, you know, she's gained some size. She's actually, I think, about 30 centimeters right now. No, that's maybe too much. I think 25. But she's getting really, really big. Basically, all of them are getting very big. So that's nice to see. My Extratosoma tiratum inisphil. I only have this female left. The male and the other female died. So yeah, I only have her left. But she is laying more than enough eggs to keep breeding them. So yeah, this is my Tiraguidia and my Extratosoma tiratum inisphil enclosure. Right here is my leaf insect enclosure. And also here, a lot of things happened. As you can see, here is a very big Pilium giganteum. Here just molted a Pilium philippinicum, sorry. And this is a male, as you can see. Maybe a cool fact to tell you is that you can see that it is a male because the body is a lot more triangle formed. I will show you a female. Okay, look, this is a female. This is just a bit more round. And a male is a bit more triangle. But yeah, all these Pilium giganteums and Pilium philippinicum are growing pretty good. Still no adults yet. Another thing, I actually got a baby nymph. Out of nowhere, a nymph hatched. It was pretty weird. I didn't even expect that to happen. But there's a nymph in here. Here you can see him. He's already getting a little green. So that's very nice. It should be a philippinicum. Oh, that's this one molted too. You can see that they recently molted by the glow, a little bit of glowing effect on their body. That indicates that they just molted. So yeah, that's very nice. So yeah, leaf insects growing really fast, doing pretty good. So yeah, let's go to the next animal. So at the moment, those are all the stick insects that I own. I have one more species at my girlfriend's house. That was the CLP species, which I showed you in the past video. Right now, I'm gonna show you all the animals that I own. These include a lot of different animals. You may already think about one, and that's Billy. Billy is my turtle, or tortoise, or however you want to call him. And I'm going to show you him right now. Here is Billy's enclosure. As you can see, I added a lamp. This is a UVA, UVB, and a heat lamp. And as you can see, he's almost underneath it, so he really likes it. Yeah, he got a basic enclosure. I got to clean it soon, because it's kind of a mess right now. But he's doing okay. He's eating pretty good. He eats a lot of these. We call it, in the Netherlands, we call this No, not on the ivy. We call this, and he eats that a lot. Oh, he didn't like me throwing that. But yeah, he's a nice turtle. Just does what turtles do. Dig in, walk like a slow old man. And yeah, it's an amazing animal. All right, I'm gonna walk to the other two animals that I'm gonna show you right now. The coolest animal I will save for last, of course. But right now we're going to the noisemakers and the guys who destroy my house. Here's the first one.
This is Gizmo, and he's a Chihuahua. We have him for about 11 years now, and he's basically the guard in this house. He makes sure no one is gonna get in, and he will show his teeth when he gets mad, but he's a nice little dog. The next is Frankie. And we actually called him to a football player from the Netherlands. And this is Frankie. Just a normal cat. They think it's a Bengal. Bengal, we call it here. And then Frankie is about 6 months old, I think. Maybe older. Don't know yet, but I think 6 months. Then another cat we own. This is Tuck. These are all Dutch names. Tuck is, I think, a little bit of a British short hair cat. Mixed with something else. But yeah, I'm also calling Garfield a lot of the times because, well, yeah, that's pretty obvious, right? Sorry for the lighting, by the way. Maybe this is better. So yeah, this is our Garfield. So yeah, two cats, one dog. And last but not least, we have a chameleon. And you may see this cage on the left here. This was the cage he was living in before. And yesterday we actually bought a new one for him. And it looks just amazing. And here he is. Right now he's a bit dark from color. Maybe he wants to come on my hand. Most of the time when he gets on my hand, he gets a lot brighter. I will show you that right now. This is nice with the lightning. Look how beautiful he is. This is a very beautiful chameleon. This is a panther chameleon. And I really love him. Just a very nice chameleon. In the enclosure, we actually made a waterfall system, which you can see here. And he really likes to drink from that. And yeah, so that's basically the last animal.
I actually ended with the chameleon. And then I walked through the house and I thought, wait a second, I forgot something. So here are the last animals that I own. And these are actually hamsters. Yeah, they are Russian dwarf hamsters, I think they are called in English. Just tiny hamsters. I bought them for my girlfriend, but my girlfriend didn't really like them. And right now I'm caring for them. They're not in my room because they make a lot of noise. And they also smell kind of bad. But yeah, that's basically the hamster. Alright guys, that was the video for today. Next video, I will actually make a recommendation video about what species is best to buy about stick insects. So yeah, I'm gonna make a video of that. Also one thing I want to mention, I had a exam week for school, so I had a lot of tests that I had to take. So far I made all of them, so I'm pretty happy that that went out good, or that went well. Next week I have holiday, so I'm gonna make a lot of videos in that week. So if you have a lot of ideas about videos that I can make, please comment it down below so I can make as much videos as possible, and that gives me a lot of rest, so I don't really have to make a video every week. So yeah, I want to thank all of you for watching, thank all of you for subscribing. If you liked the video, please put a thumbs up. If you want to see more of these videos, please subscribe, and I'll see you the next one.